Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to our XCOM 2 Commander playthrough. We're ready to do Operation Demon Mask, a simple guerrilla operation where we need to protect a device. I don't think we actually ever needed to protect a device in the past before, but I did one small adjustment. I made one small adjustment in that I removed Ulrich's EMP bomb and swapped it out for a flashbang. The reason for that is that the shadow chamber doesn't indicate that there are any mechanical units in this this mission. So the only mechanical unit will be the codex and everything else should be organic or otherwise. So let's head on into the Sky Ranger and head to where we need to go. I think it's West Africa. There we go, West Africa.
Ready to deploy.
Apparently the Resistance has been relying on an old data tap along the Advent network that had, up until this point, been eluding the aliens' detection. Recent intel suggests the data the Resistance found is critical to the aliens' latest operation. Unfortunately, Advent is already moving to take out the device, and we can't let that happen. Eliminate all hostile contacts and secure the area. Protect that device at all costs.
So important in this kind of mission is that we move fast. So the aliens will be firing at the device constantly as long as we don't try and do something to stop them. So here we go. There we go, dropping in. So speed will be of the essence.
We need to lock down the area and secure the device at all costs.
But we have the advantage that we start out concealed, so we're gonna move everybody closer and I'll get back to you guys when we spot something. Oh, and there we have our first enemy, apparently. An Archon blasting into the scene. The other thing is, we need to protect that device, so even after a few shots, that thing might be destroyed already. The important thing there is that we don't really have a timer, but of course if the device is destroyed, then we're gonna have a bit of a problem. Similar as to the fact that we have a problem right now, because that Archon, of course, has a lot of health. And we should prioritize taking it down, but there's probably more enemies where that came from. And I split the guys up in two teams of three for this mission. So let's get closer over here. Put Vinny over here, down here.
Confirmed.
And then Emma, I'm going to let you check the hack already just to see what we can find. What benefits we can get from hacking that pole over there. Because it's possible that we can... Ooh. Okay, squad recovers all action points already spent this turn. So that is amazing. And that's a 100% chance. So we are going to use that in a minute. So I am going to put her over here on the corner.
Understood. Moving out.
And then I don't have any reason not to start firing at that Archon over there. So I'm gonna put Christoph over here.
Roger that.
Hopefully seeing a bit more of the area. There we go. That's what I wanted to see. And then I think Ulrich should be the one to start it off. So as always, Ulrich, get in there and toss a grenade out in the open. I'm going on a limb here that we're going to get everything back, so it's not even a guess. We're going to get everything back, so let's just explode the Archon and that's a normal Lancer. With a bit of armor, but still a normal Lancer. There we go. Archon very, very pissed. And activated. There we go. Yes, yes, yes. Very mad you are. They're gonna come closer like that. Christoph hasn't been alerted yet, which is interesting. I'm gonna open the door that Vinny is next to, and I'm wondering how many aliens he'll be able to see. Apparently, only the Archon. So I'm gonna use his lightning hands. Yep, there we go. And that was a Magnificent miss.
Missed.
Yes, indeed, you missed. And then a normal pistol shot to try that again. 3 damage, so that's the lowest he can do. Did he already do a battle frenzy? No, he didn't. There we go, battle frenzy. And then we have a shotgun shot with Kistoff, so that could almost take out the Archon. The elite trooper over there could... I could actually try that, but I might have a better idea. So, Hugh, can you get around here and try to take out the Lancer now that we're here? There we go, 91% should be a clean kill. There we go, blasted his brains right out of his helmet. Yeah, whatever that meant. My French isn't that good. 33% shot. Well, Yang has been known to hit really, really low percentage shots, so maybe? And if it doesn't, it might actually take out his cover. Seems to have taken out the lower portion of the house.
Not even close.
But not the upper portion for some reason. What else do we have? We have Christophe's shotgun shot, which... You know what? Why not? There are only 9 enemies on this map. So, if we're successful, we can actually kill... Wait, what? Oh, Christophe already did something, so never mind. Let's just hack the pole. That was completely the intention. And let's get all our action points back. And murder the hell out of those guys. So, soldier gains complete. I would have swapped those two, because squad recovers all action points. It's a lot better, but 100% it is. I think we would have just gotten 50 as well, but distraction. There we go, all action points returned, and now we can do whatever the fuck we want. Hugh, how close can you get to that guy over there? I could actually even try and flank that guy to hell. Yeah. But Ulrich, you can fire twice if I'm not mistaken. So fire twice at the Archon, please. And try to take it out. That is one magnificent hit. He dodged it, but it was 4 damage nonetheless. Yes, you kind of missed for a bit. And he's battle frenzying again. But Ulrich. Wait, what? Ulrich, oh. So this technically counts as still the same turn. And since he moved... Okay, never mind. 90% shot, that's actually really good. Really, really good. I do want to start getting a bit closer as well. Oh shit, she saw something else.
Advent force is sighted.
Yeah, I should have known that would happen.
We're near the objective.
Ooh, and I see a codex over there as well. On the right. Did we trigger that one as well? Because we didn't. Oh, they're actually coming out. That is good. Because I have a surprise for you guys. Acid bomb away. That is really on the edge, but I can hit all of them. So, goodbye. There we go. Grenade one out. Boosh! So all the acid shredded. So all the armor shredded by acid, of course. Didn't mean that. We could get Christophe to... We have a few options here. I think what I want to do is, of course, use face-off for the first time. But maybe try and shoot once at... Do I just shoot once at the... Because this is my first turn, right? So it's only one action. There we go. And then I should be able to use face-off, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, okay, there we go. Let's try that for the very first time. Face-off. And you get a pistol shot. And you get a... What are you doing? The fuck?
Yeah, I didn't get it.
He missed 3 times, but that was very, very weird. Okay, we do have another incendiary grenade if I want to take out most of the guys over there. So let's drop down.
On your order.
With Emma. And get her behind the tree over there. And then try and see what we can do with the incendiary bomb. I think I can hit two of them. Which is good. Can I get that a bit further? No, I can't. So let's just take out those two guys. Bombs away. And that should kill off at least the shield bearer. I'm not sure if the officer will survive, but Christoph. Do I use rapid fire on the Archon? 275s opposite to 190 shot. I think I'm gonna do rapid fire just to be sure. Blammo. One was enough. 15 damage. That was, I think he felt that. And then Implacable allows him to move. And then I think I'm gonna move him over here.
Whatever you say.
And then Hugh, can you? Because there's still a trooper over there. He wasn't visible for a second there, but I think if I put Hugh over here, we know the last batch is at the other side of the house where the Vice is. Oh, and it's already a flank shot. That guy doesn't have any cover anymore. Goodbye! Thank you very much. 11 damage. So that sadly means that we still have two enemies left, if I'm not mistaken. Because he takes damage from the acid burn and then from the normal fire burn. Acid burn damage. What's the Lancer gonna do, I wonder? Because, there we go, the officer burned to death. And now the Lancer's probably gonna run through the fire. I kind of made a danger zone over there. He's running away. Did he just stab the device? Hey, dickhead. Did you just do what I think you just did? God damn it. Because now he's out there, of course. Yeah, and go take a look. And Emma. Wait, Yan, can you see him? Yeah, you can. So 80% on the heavy Lancer. Because that's actually a flank shot, so yeah, take it. Goodbye. That's another enemy less. So now we still need to get close pretty fast so we can take out the last batch of enemies. I don't have Jazz to reconceal, but that's not really necessary since we kind of know where they are. I'm gonna boost Vinny over here. Over there, thank you very much. And then just, I'm gonna have to wait one turn to do what I want to do. Ulrich can go further as well. And Emma can go behind the tree over here, shouldn't trigger anything else. And Smongo, yeah, you're gonna go as fast as you can towards the building. And then a few Overwatch shots with everybody else who's still got an action left. There we go. And he gets Overwatch automatically. So now, apparently nobody tried to fire at the device, which is fine by me. I'm gonna put Yang a bit closer, probably triggering the group that's still behind there. Yeah, there we go. Two codexes and an Archon. Interesting. Yes, you're very mad. Very mad indeed. So the codexes have put themselves in a very strategic position because I can't really get a grenade in there without damaging the device. The device still has a lot of HP left, so that's not really a problem. What I'm going to do is try and get at least one pistol shot on one of those codexes over there. I could actually just fire at one, but the percentage is too low to my tastes to even warrant a shot. So try and get a bit closer, Vinny. And then Emma can get towards the cactus. Hugh. Don't really have a good position for Hugh. Maybe over here behind the bench. I could use the mimic beacon as a safeguard against any attacks on the device or us, of course. But I do want to try and take out at least one of them. But Ulrich. You have the flashbang. So if I use you to How far can you get that flashbang from over here? Oh, it actually does damage now as well. I can actually flashbang everybody in this. Ooh. But I wonder if that removes the loot, because I do want to have that loot. Christoph, how far does your running gun lead? Oh, just not far enough. But I'm going to activate and see what we can do.
Go in for the kill.
Oh no, you have the mimic beacon. God damn it. Kind of wasted that, but... Ulrich, then I'm going to see... Well, I'm going to learn what the flashbang does. Because I'm afraid it's going to destroy the loot, since it now does damage. But hey, let's get it in there. Get it in there. I think that hits everything. I kind of a weird position, but that's the best I can do, apparently. 3-2-1, flashbang out in the open, and he's inside of Vinny. There we go, and I think, yeah, the device took damage from that as well, but the loot is still there. No remark from Bradford over there that I just damaged something. Apparently not. So now the codexes can't split, by the way. So once they're disoriented, they can split away. So I think I might focus my fire at the Archon. Just to pelt it down. 6 damage is really, really good. Thank you, Yang.
Training
ammo fast, of course, but that's not that bad. Then Vinny. Fire a pistol shot at... Well, yeah, the codex you have the best shot at. Hopefully killing it. Oh, that was a miss. That was too bad.
Adjusting sights.
Yeah, you should. You really, really should. Emma could technically shock the codexes, but apparently that doesn't increase the damage for some reason, so I might just fire my weapon at... Can't kill the codexes either, so just at the Archon. There we go, 7 solid damage on that Archon. And then we have Christoph and Hugh. Hugh has a shot at the codex that I'm just gonna take because I can. Ooh, 8 damage, that was in the face, but he can't split normally. Nope, because of the disorientation. And now we're gonna put Christoph a bit closer. And just set the mimic beacon up out there in the open. Maybe behind this tree, so they're forced to come outside. Maybe, although it could be that some of the codexes don't spot that. So maybe just... over here. That's certain that they both can see that. Maybe even here. Let's put it over there. There we go. Isn't that cover? Because he's not ducking. The mimic beacon is not ducking. So there goes the Archon. Firing at the mimic beacon with a beam shot. 7 damage. That should help it to tank. Ooh. No, he's only going to be able to tank one more shot, I think. But the codex is a bit confused, and then the other codex goes over there, and... That was their turn. Yep, that made that interesting. What can we do? I think... Yeah, that one codex now is out in the open, so if I just fire my pistol shot... My free first... Well, not free first pistol shot, but... Full ammo! That was a dodge. Seriously?
That didn't do much.
Yeah, that indeed didn't do much. So let's fire again. This time killing it. Hopefully. Oh, for fuck's sake. Double dodge? Seriously?
I got a piece.
Yeah, you got a piece. That's pretty much all you got. Christoph, come a bit closer.
I can handle that.
And use your shotgun to, well, the storm gun, to finish off the... Oh. Well, yeah, to finish off the Archon, hopefully. There we go, 16 damage in the face. In the face.
Impressed yet?
His armor looks really nice with the orange. It kind of fits the sword as well. What else can we do? I should go... I'm just gonna go inside. Just because I can. And I wanna get that loot. There we go, take the loot. Advanced stock and a laser sight. We haven't been really lucky with good upgrades. 100% on the codex, which is really good, because I think I can kill the last codex with Emma if I want to. Ouch, that looked painful. That was 11 damage.
That's right.
Straight in the face. Out of rounds, but that's not bad, because now we can use Emma to just combat protocol the hell out of that codex. And finishing this mission in record time, I think. Because we got all the enemies really, really quickly. There we go, codex killed, and that's probably the last enemy if I'm not mistaken. 9 enemies set the shadow chamber. There we go.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed, mission accomplished.
Flawless, 9 enemies in 5 turns, that was amazing. There we go! So Yang dealt most damage for once. Vinny made most attacks with his pistols, of course, and Memory Beacon under fire most, and Kristoff, as always, moved the furthest. We did get a new record in average damage per attack and average enemy skill per turn, just because we finished that mission off really, really quickly. But that's some really nice stats, guys. Really, really nicely done. Even with those few lower level soldiers in there, everybody did a perfect job. Back at the Avenger, as always, we're gonna kick back and relax, drink some margaritas. You guys earned it. Go to the bar immediately.
Another heroic effort in the
sadly, no promotions, which is interesting because we did kill 9 enemies and only one of those was killed by Kristoff, who has max level. So, interesting. 2 Codex Brains, an advanced stock laser sight, and the corpses of everything we killed. Yeah, indeed.
Another impressive effort, Commander. My expectations were high, and yet you have exceeded
well,
them.
We aim to please, Councilman. And there we got Vasily Smirnov, an engineer, probably from Russian descent, if I'm not mistaken. And we blocked the Viper rounds, and he has a lot of work ahead of him. Look at that. So let's put that engineer into clearing alien debris further and faster. There we go. Thank you, Vasily. There we go. In 8 days, that will be cleared out. And the power relay will be done in 1 as well. Interesting, interesting, interesting. I do realize that I put my rooms in a really odd position mostly. Which is not that bad of an issue. Not big of an issue. So let's go to the bridge, because I think we're still scanning... No, we were making that radio relay. That's right. Gorilla op. That is interesting. Never seen that. What? You can investigate something on a map to get an extra mission. That is... interesting. I was building a radio relay, so we're gonna do that first.
Power relay now operational.
Power relay completed, so that increases the power capacity by 10. Let's check that out really quickly. So that's a normal power relay. Do I somehow see how much that does? Because I want to see which one of those isn't built on a power coil. So this one I upgraded, but I think these two are both on a power coil, if I'm not mistaken. I can easily see that if I remove one of those, but give me a second.
Shen managed to pull a set of encoded coordinates from the vial we recovered at the alien black site, and it looks like we're headed towards another as of yet unidentified facility. There are a bunch of theories floating around as to what we'll find. But at this point, I'm not ready to commit to anything until I see for myself.
Yeah, for now, I'm gonna just keep it like that. So let's get back to the bridge and probably get the war suit in a second. So continue doing that. There we go. War suit complete. This powered heavy battle armor grants massive damage resistance and survivability, as well as a wrist-mounted heavy weapon hardpoint. The war suit can also generate temporary cover for allies with its powerful shield wall technology. And an experimental powered weapon, as our technology has continued to evolve in lockstep with our understanding of the aliens' own designs, it should now be possible to fabricate even more powerful weaponry for our heavy armor suits. So So let's quickly check that out.
Recruiting new staff for the
but
team.
Yeah, I know, Shen. I know. Jesus Christ.
We can have them working on construction, excavation, or staffing a facility.
We never really created a heavy suit because the exosuit is also a heavy suit, but we never made one. Those are mounted with one or of a few kinds of different heavy weapons. So the normal thing is, I think, a rocket launcher. That's mounted on there. So now we can actually create an experimental powered weapon that's actually more powerful than the original version. But we'll see that once we use that war suit in the field. I don't have any Illyrium cores left. So we're going to have to wait with that. I'm also going to start clearing the next area. Just because we can, we have an extra engineer available. So there we go. And then a few minutes later, we get the Archon autopsy completed, so let's check out what we can get.
It certainly is impressive looking, if nothing else. Although I am still not entirely sure what the aliens hope to achieve with such a grand design.
Well, I think it's more of a intimidation tactic, but hey. Brief eyewitness accounts, including one from our own central officer Bradford, indicate that the aliens once fielded a similar biomechatronic organism during the earliest days of the invasion. Those reports, however, describe a much more gruesome and rudimentary creature versus the subject we encounter in the present day, because they're talking about the floaters of the previous game. The modern specimen could almost be described as elegant in appearance, an authoritative, intimidating figure with the advanced weaponry to match. And the fusion blade is available. The fusion blade encases a plasma-heated metallic core in a micro-tin magnetic field, jabber-jabber, enabling devastating melee attacks that are capable of setting enemies aflame. So that's going to be amazing for Jazz, and the Advent Trooper autopsy is now instant.
Knowing that my past surgical experience is limited, I am sure the crew appreciates that I hone my skills on fallen Advent forces before triaging our own wounded. To the uninitiated, the common Advent Trooper is seemingly human. The aliens have disguised this most glaring divergence from the human form with a carefully designed helmet. Despite a thorough analysis, I have yet to discover what, if any, advantage the Advent hybrid soldiers' enormous eyes provide. Testing their visual acuity will no doubt prove difficult.
So yes, because they have astoundingly huge eyes, but the most public face of Advent security, the standard Advent Trooper serves in a first response role in areas of high public exposure. Although rumors as to their origins have persisted for years, it's only recently that we've confirmed that they are in fact the product of a human-alien hybrid development. My initial autopsy indicates that the troopers were at one time entirely human, implying some means of gradual genetic enhancement without rejection concerns that would normally plague these experiments. The body itself maintains the general outward appearance of a typical human, with the most crucial changes occurring in the cranial structure. It is my belief that the Advent Troopers receive their orders, that is to say, are controlled directly through a psionic link engineered as part of the genetic modification process. As we first discovered in the field, the eyes are notably larger, perhaps as an unintended side effect, as they seem to provide only limited improvements to the troopers' visual acuity. The aliens have managed to disguise this glaring physical trait from the general public through the use of cleverly designed armor. So they're it's a fancy way of saying that they hide the eyes in the helmet. So new item available, the battle scanner. The battle scanner provides extra vision on the battlefield. Soldiers deploy it like a grenade, throwing it to a hidden area of the map that they want to reveal. Any hidden or disguised enemies will be revealed as well. So the same effect as the scanner that Benito already uses. We could just put in another bit of research, because there's a few more interesting ones as well. But let's go with the plasma lens, so we can upgrade the sniper rifle when we get there.
I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
There we go. Research fixed with the plasma lens, and now we have a few more days left again. Can we build the relay without any disturbances? Yes, we can. So new income, and we get the continent bonus. Black market items cost 33% less intel. Good. Very, very good. I think we might as well go for the extra guerrilla operation. now that we have it. Because we then get another guerrilla operation before the next supply drop, which would be really cool. So let's just go there. And I must say the Avatar project is really, really slow going at the moment. It has been a while since we had any progress of the sort. But let's scan here. And there we go, dark event completed. The aliens step up their construction efforts, reducing the alien facility counter by 2 weeks. There we go. That was the hidden event, I think. So the next facility will be completed faster. And that's actually in our benefit, I think. But yeah, let's just continue scanning. Raid suit completed. The lightweight variant of our powered armor system not only boosts our soldiers' reflexes and speed, it also incorporates experimental warp technology, permitting the wearer to briefly change dimensional phase and effortlessly pass through right through obstacles. One raid suit has been added to the inventory. And I don't think, yeah, it doesn't grant us any more special missions or proven ground experiments. Next up is clearing the alien debris that we'll probably complete. There we go. 119 supplies. We can do something with that. We could put another room here, but I'm gonna wait. Because we have more space. We're gonna need more space in a minute. Next completion will be the plasma lance. There we go.
I think I could have predicted this outcome, though it is intriguing.
With the variety of hostile forces our soldiers are tasked with facing, it seems only logical to provide them with varying alternative means of engaging the enemy, in this case from a much greater range than previously thought possible. By focusing the standard plasma bolt through a series of modulating rings, a single powerful shot capable of devastating targets at extreme range can be produced. As is typically the case, the limitations of our environment preclude us from fully testing the bounds of these new plasma-based sniper rifles outside of a simulated environment. Regardless, I'm sure our troops will be eager to find these new limits on their own in the field, and I expect to hear of their exploits for some time to come. The aliens' focused beam technology has obvious applications for improving sniper rifles. The Plasma Lance is an unmatched sniper rifle. Then, I think it's high time we start going into psionics, because we haven't really gone into that for now. Because we can actually make psionic soldiers in this game as well. Let's go to engineering.
I am intrigued by the idea that despite the Codex's best efforts to resist our intrusion into the Advent network, we somehow came away with a set of coordinates leading to an otherwise uninhabited region. The aliens certainly keep us on the move, one way or another.
Yeah, and we're gonna get to that mission rather soon, but first, build items.
Hello, Commander.
Hello, Shen. Let's see, we could go for the Fusion Blade, Beam Cannon, or Plasma Lance. Plasma Lance, we need a few more supplies for that, so I think I'm just gonna go for the Beam Cannon, since we use two Grenadiers most of the time, and they can use the upgrade. So yeah, beam cannon upgrade, there we go. So out of supplies again, but never you mind. Bridge.
All those people. God damn it.
Why do you do that? Why do you start conversations like that? Never mind. There we go. A gang claiming control of this area has somehow eluded Advent's patrols and established a stronghold. We send an envoy to meet with the gang's leader, and we're able to convince him to redirect the gang's hostility towards Advent directly. Okay, so guerrilla operation, new target, New India. So we get only one mission, but it does counter one dark event immediately, and we do get a lot of supplies from that. 11 enemies, heavy mech, elite lancer, archon, muton, enemy unknown, which is very interesting, elite shield bearer, andromedon, and viper. So pretty much everything we could get. So let's check that out.
Setting course for India.
Because we're gonna need a pretty big team to actually pull this off. Do we need a healer or do we want the firepower instead? I think it might be a good idea to start using... Oh, I do want to get Hugh here as well. If only I could make bigger teams than this. If only I could make bigger teams than this. But we do need a hacker. We always need a hacker, especially with those robotic enemies that could give us the edge we need. Kistov is still a safe bet because of his run and gun ability, so I still want to keep him in there. So I'm gonna give Jazz the Raid suit.
Provides a range of movement that technically violates the laws of physics. There's also a grappling hook for good measure.
So the only thing he's missing here is armor, but his mobility, dodge, and of course a few abilities have been added. So extra mobility, extra dodge. There's a grappling hook in this thing as well. And you can pass through objects for two turns if you want to. We do lose one slot in the inventory screen, but giving him the beacon has always been the best shot he gets. So there we go. That's the raid suit, and I think I'm gonna... I swapped around the grenades a bit as well. And I think I'm gonna give Yang the war suit if I can. And that should allow her to tank pretty much everything that the game can throw at her. Look at that.
We're calling this heavy power armor the war suit. This is as tough and strong as we can make it, with plenty of power for handling heavy weapons.
And there's an added rocket launcher, if I'm not mistaken. There we go. So rocket launcher mounted to that. I think it only does 4 to 7 damage and a 4 radius, but I think it's boosted by the abilities as well. So we still have 2 acid bombs, and I think I'm going to swap her plasma grenade for the hazmat vest, giving her 16 health, 2 armor, and 12 mobility. So that's pretty good. And she looks amazing in that suit as well. If we can add more stuff to it, we will. But for now, that's pretty much what she can do. And that's going to be the team we're going to head into that mission with in Operation Wolf Saga, the extra guerrilla operation of this month. My voice is kind of leaving me, so I'm going to leave it at that. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video series. Goodbye.